this. What is up, guys? Gamer here, and today we are doing a top 10 horror movies. So let's get going. Number 10, Friday the 13th. Friday the 13th starts off at Camp Crystal Lake. A camp where a young boy drowned and his mother seeks revenge. I'm talking about the first Friday the 13th, not the remake. So I hope you guys will enjoy that. But this is the scariest, as I'm going to say right now, this is going to be the scariest movies that IMDb says, and basically movies that you should watch around this holiday. So I hope you guys will enjoy it. Okay, now on to the next one. Number 9. Alien. A film that basically says what it means. Basically, imagine this. You're on a spaceship with a crew. You basically are space truckers. And then when you guys landed on a planet because of a distress signal, you easily find yourself in the horde of the Xenomorphs. Basically, this is another movie to watch during this holiday because people love to watch sci-fi, people love to watch horror, so it's a sci-fi horror movie. Check it out. Number 8. Evil Dead 2. Why did I say Evil Dead 2? Because of Ash cutting his arm off and basically getting himself his own replacement arm of a chainsaw hand. And plus, he is really good. Bruce Campbell's really good in this movie, even though this is when he was not good at acting. Okay. Number 7. Child's Play is a demonic. It's basically a demonic toy movie, which has Charles Lee Ray as the War Strangler become Chucky the Killer Doll. And Chucky the Killer Doll basically is a toy that gets possessed by him with voodoo. If you're gonna watch it, even though it could be a Christmas, it could be around Christmas time where you guys can watch it, or around any time. It's a good movie. And watch the series. By the way, most of these things have franchises for this top 10, so hope you guys will enjoy it. But never mind. Let's just get back on the road. Number 6. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Leatherface and a whole family of cannibals. Okay. Well, I'm talking about the original, and plus I hate the remake by Michael Bay for every single one of the ones that were remade by Michael Bay, but The Texas Chainsaw Massacre was a good movie franchise, and basically I actually liked the way Leatherface looked. He looked exactly like a killer that is a cannibal might look like. Plus, it was based off a true story. That's one reason to watch it. Number 5.
Number 5.
You're starting the commencement of the annual Purge. The Purge. Okay, I haven't seen this movie at all, but here's the things I see in the trailer. Basically, the Purge is a holiday that has all crime be legal for 24 hours at the horn, which basically I believe that it is a good franchise because you can easily do a lot with the Purge. Basically, you can make your own version of the Purge and do your own videos of it. I don't know, but hey, it's just a Purge. Number 1. No, the Purge. So, see you guys later.
Number 4. The one, the only, the original Halloween. The night he came home.
Halloween, number 1, is basically a good movie because you can easily see that it has some potentials. Even though there's this little thing known as the black sheep of the whole franchise known as Season of the Witch, which basically is technically based around actual Halloween, but yeah, never mind. Just watch the original Halloween series and you guys will actually be amazed.
Number 3. Scream.
Okay, the Scream costume was actually Ghostface. A Ghostface costume that was just used for the person's own purposes. Basically, they thought, hey, look, let's just make a movie about a costume that's already out and just make it so it goes on until the TV series. In the TV series, they changed the costume, so I hope you guys will enjoy that. See you guys.
Number 2. Do you want to play a game?
It's Saw. Saw is a messed up movie with basically, you are trapped. You basically have a hard time getting away from Jigsaw and his puppets. But hey, it's a movie that is basically based around horror and torture.
See you guys.
And taking the number 1 spot on our list is Nightmare on Elm Street. Freddy Krueger is a killer inside this movie. And basically, transitioning to here, I did the death of Johnny Depp. RIP Johnny Depp in Nightmare on Elm Street. And basically, I actually thought that a lot of this was good. It did some nice good scenes, like when Johnny was ripped under the bed, blood gushed out of the bed, and all of that. That was actually pretty good. Even though they already used that type of scene later or earlier with Army of Darkness. So, yeah, enjoyed that. But hey, if you guys haven't seen these horror movies at all, you guys might have been sleeping under a rock, like this guy.
I'm home. your guts.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this top 10, and by the way, I have to go find Necronomicon now, and also the Bombonomicon and the Gamonomicon. So I hope you guys enjoy. See you guys in the next Inferno. Oh, actually, see you guys in the next Dimensional Inferno, and good luck.